در زمانی که مرحوم آیت الله العظما
When the late Grand Ayatollah Haji Hossein Tabatabai Borujerdi, who was the religious authority for Shiites the world over, passed away, my late father and a number of other clergymen, including Imam Khomeini, were introduced as the religious authorities of the Shiites. In 1381 AH, which is about 48 or 50 years ago, he was recognized as one of the greatest religious authorities, and many people from Iran and other countries in the vicinity of the Persian Gulf, as well as Pakistan, Lebanon, and Iraq, imitated him.
خلیج فارس و پاکستان و لبنان و عراق از ایشون تقلید کردند.
مرکز میکروگرافی یا میکروفوتوگرافی کتابخونه هست.
This is Riz Micrography or Microphotography Center. Here we take pictures of manuscripts by scanning them and making microfilms. This is usually done to prevent deterioration of delicate manuscripts or to facilitate information exchange among scholarly centers. In this unit, a microfilm of the manuscripts is initially created using high-tech cameras. These cameras are able to record very minute parts and dimensions such as ID cards and stamps, as well as large pages such as the page of a newspaper. The size of the page poses no problem. After this stage, which is almost automatic, the films are taken to processing, which consists of a processing machine and chemicals. They are also immunized against disruptive lights of the environment. Then they enter the utilization stage.
در بخش قراردادها این کتابخانه با سفارتخانه‌ها در ارتباط است.
In our public relations department, we have relations with embassies and libraries for cataloging and training people. We also hold exhibitions and seminaries, and all of this information is published in our specialized journal called Shahab. Moreover, we write good articles about books and bookkeeping, which are invaluable. We also have a notebook in which our visitors write some points about the library. We'll have a look at it together.
After processing, the films are taken to quality control, where they are checked piece by piece with machines specified for this task. If the page has a problem in terms of clarity, layout, or similar things, they are corrected. If the films are recorded imperfectly and they are continued on the next roll, the films are attached to each other by the splicer machine and are sent to the archive as complete films.
He embarked on a pilgrimage to Mashhad and Qom. While he was in the latter, he also visited some relatives that lived there. He met a lot of friendly people in Tehran and Qom, so he decided to stay in Iran for a while and learn what he could from its people. After some months, in 1343 AH, he went to Qom to visit the tomb of Hazrat Masuma, peace be upon her, and to visit Haj Sheikh Abdul Karim Hayri Yazdi, the founder of the newly opened Theological School of Qom. After this visit, Mr. Hayri asked my father to stay in Qom to teach. That was during the reign of Reza Shah, and the Theological School and the city of Qom in general were under a lot of pressure. My father said that he lived in Najaf and taught there, but Mr. Hayri kept insisting, so he finally gave in.
Bulgarian calligraphy among the calligraphies of the Amhari books. As one of the visitors said, if there was only a handful of books in the world, half of them would be in this beautiful library. Suryani, Hebrew, and Armenian calligraphies used in the Bible and Western Coptic calligraphy next to Pahlavi and Sanskrit. The Ten Commandments of Buddha decorated with beautiful Buddhist calligraphy and two splendid copies in the Punjabi and Burmese from India. I bought the book with my wages for 3 months of prayer by proxy. I'm in dire straits and I'm hungry. I haven't eaten anything for one day and night. I bought the book with my wages for 4 months of prayer by proxy, and I bought another book about medicine with annotations with my wages from 6 months of prayer by proxy. I haven't eaten anything for 3 days. The book Kashfulayat va Istilahat. The notes on its back cover indicate 20 hours of hunger, and the price of this book equals the wages of 24 months of prayer by proxy. And another book with a higher price, which amounts to nearly 4 years of prayer by proxy. A 200-year-old book which indicates the greatness of ancient Iran and makes any Iranian visitor feel proud. Ilm-e-Jal, written by Shams al-Omara Muhammad Fakhreddin on geometry with three-dimensional ordered shapes which attracts the attention of any visitor. Near the greatest geometry book is the book on astronomy. Books about, for example, cosmology, written by Qattan Marwazi Najari, and another book named Zayj Ilkhani, written by Khaja Nasiruddin Tusi, and another called Zayj Nasiri by Mahmud ibn Omar, about 800 to 900 years old. contemporary well-known scholars, we can refer to martyr Sheikh Fazlullah Nuri and his calligraphy. An enchanting script was used in the book, Salat by Sheikh Ansari. The calligraphy of Shahid Sani, the second martyr, and Sheikh Baha'i, and a book by Sheikh Ta'ife called Tazhib al-Ahkam, with the calligraphy of the father of Sheikh Baha'i. The calligraphy of the great and distinguished scholar Mullah Sadra Shirazi is really beautiful. Its subjects are hadith and exegesis. Three examples of splendid, costly Sunni books in this library. The first is Mujam al-Sahabe by Baghawi, and another is about the virtues of Imam Ali, peace be upon him, which is by the son of Imam of Hanbalis, Abdullah ibn Ahmad ibn Hanbal Shaybani. And the third is the Hamdi Andalusi. These are the Psalms of Hazrat David. It is about 800 years old and is written in the Latin alphabet on goatskin. The word Amen can be seen at the end of hymns and prayers. It is inscribed beautifully. Titles for the beginnings of hymns and prayers, which are sung with a beautiful melody from early in the morning till late at night on weekdays and special days. One good occasion is evening prayers, which is sung at the beginning of the night. A 200-page goatskin book weighing 16 kilograms with a wooden lid, metal corners, and a leather cover. A book can be either misleading or guiding, but a printed book which is available in this treasury of manuscript is the biography of the dethroned king of Iran, which is named A Mission for My Homeland. His picture is printed on its metal cover. Misleading books. The second misleading book is in this exquisite box. It is beautiful in appearance and dark in essence. It is a book against which Imam Khomeini revolted in 1342 according to the Islamic solar calendar. It is the book White Revolution by the Shah of Iran. It is written with the script of Abdur Rasuli and contains expensive gildings in its margins. It is kept in Sharif Imami's home and was delivered to this library after the Islamic Revolution.
بعد از اینکه کار تفکیک سازی میکروفیلم ها انجام شد
and microfilms are sorted. Their serial numbers and catalog numbers are written on their covers. Their covers, which are considered their ID cards, are wrapped around them. Then the films are kept in an archive. An archive is a place with a lot of files. The microfilms in the files are identified by three numbers on them. The first number is the file number, the second is the drawer number, and the last is their row number. Since these microfilms are very sensitive, they are put in a plastic box and kept in a closed place to protect them from dust and light. This preserves their quality and adds to their longevity.
The construction began, but my father said he knew that he would never live to see the library completed. 3 months later, he passed away. On the last night of his life, he said a glorious congregational prayer and then went home very slowly and ate a light supper. Most nights he ate bread and boiled zucchini. Then he lay down and passed away very easily and without any difficulties because he was oppressed rather than an oppressor. I don't know anybody who can say that he had swindled them.
I will never forget the time when I went to visit him at the end of his fruitful life. He was sick and bedridden. A number of the scholars were clustering around him. Knowing that a sick person, whether a great person or a child or a person like him, should have high spirits, I told him that he had done much for humanity. But two of his did outshone the others. I continued by saying that the first service was reviving the book Ihqaq al-Haq, which is about the greatness of the Imams and is a Sunni source, which was originally compiled by the late Qazi Shushtari. Ayatollah Marashi managed a group in order to add some information to that book by conducting some widespread research. And I said, the second service is this huge library, which is the honor of the Shiite world, and your service is very outstanding. When he heard my gratitude, his weakness seemed to disappear, and he sat up.
He once told me that death was like a wedding for him. The previous manager of the shrine of Hazrat Masumeh allocated a grave for him just 2 meters away from the shrine. But he said very humbly that he would be proud to be buried near his esteemed ancestor, but to bury him instead in the corridor of the library, which he had established under the feet of the scholars who come there to learn the sciences. This is written in his will too, and we complied with it and buried him there. ما هم این رو اجابت کردیم و در راهروی کتابخانه ایشون رو دفن کردیم.